Our next speaker is Joshua Smith.
Hello. Thank you. Yes, a better world without religion. I'm against this motion as a Christian. A couple of points, actually a lot of my points have already been covered, thankfully. But yeah, a couple of points in response to the other side. The other side. a lot of valid points. Thank you for that, and challenging as well. But I think we do need to keep in mind that there are a lot of cultural kind of connotations with those. I really should have taken notes on this, shouldn't I? But yeah, I'm sure we'll cover those in the question time. Right, I'll start with my one then. Religion is the opium of the people, a quote that Josh used, actually. I feel it is a little bit misquoted sometimes. With the whole quote, it is, religion is the sigh of the oppressed creature, the heart of a heartless world, and the soul of soulless conditions. It is the opium of the people. Marx could see the effects of religion. They were there. Marx was talking about the positive, as it were, effects of religion. They were the comfort for the people. It wasn't an opium, so, I mean, in this reference, I don't believe that Marx was saying this was an opium so that the government could steal their dreams. It was, in fact, their coping mechanism. A lot of people have said to me personally and to a lot of other people, you know, isn't religion just for the weak? And I would say, yes, it is. In Luke 5, verse 31, excuse me for using the Bible, but... Well, it is our scripture. It is not, Jesus says, it is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick. So, religion is for the weak. And I guess it's up to us to define, you know, what is weak, what is... all these things. I don't particularly agree with Marx about the fact that religion needs to be gotten rid of. But, that's an aside. It's actually the point. And a couple of positives about religion. It provides a unifying force, a cohesivity in society, a point that is actually picked up by the other side. I don't believe this necessarily means that we have to kind of hate each other and distrust people who are outside of this. In fact, an Archbishop of Canterbury, I can't remember which one it was quite a while ago, said the church... I don't know, I'm not saying he's completely correct in this, but he said the church is the only society on earth that is based for the members that are not in it, for its non-members. And as Nye pointed out about his experiences with Muslims, it's not an exclusive thing. I think it can be, which is a shame. But this goes against the teachings that I've heard, at least. Some of the values that it promotes, I'm talking from my experience in the Bible here, the story of the Samaritan, the Good Samaritan, you know, love your neighbour. Who is your neighbour? It could be anyone. It's not just the people who go to your church. There's the Sermon on the Mount, don't judge others, the Beatitudes, which are kind of talking about equality, you know, being rich and being poor. Read up on it, it's good. Being the salt and light of the earth, being righteous, against the teaching of an eye for an eye, against this revenge thing, love for enemies, pure hearts and not just religion for show. Don't worry too much about things. Where did worrying ever get people? I better hurry up. The story of the wise and the foolish builders. You know, there's some good common sense in these things. And, yeah, and like Guy said, you know, these aren't all patented by the Bible, but they certainly are a good source for them, I believe. Activists for righteousness in history are often shown to be people of faith. For example, Wilberforce and Pitt against the, slavery, certainly that type of slavery, like you mentioned, the slavery in the Old Testament. You know, there would have to be a slight definition change there in terms of what slavery is. But the bishops in the House of Lords today, who are being the champions of the poor, against these the welfare cuts and the lawyer things. Just want to quickly say about science and development. Contrary to popular belief, science has often been promoted by the things in terms of universities, monasteries, which are the forefront of education, and Christian scientists there are kind of evidence of the fact that we're not all kind of backwards. In terms of development, Josh actually mentioned the NGOs and the churches, about faith-based organisations, which actually account, I think, for almost 50% of developmental NGOs.
Just that note?
Yep. Okay.